What's going on, guys? Vegas here, and today I just got finished watching the Chargers beat the Saints 26-8 in kind of a must win for the Chargers for them to stay above 500. And for me this week, it was Justin Herbert. Like, I was watching this game and the dude was playing lights out, like, for the majority or like nearly this entire game. Like, for me, watching this offense work and the position that Justin Herbert is put in when his offensive line is just struggling, especially Zion Johnson. I don't know how many times that dude just got beat right off the snap. But for Justin Herbert to be able to just avoid sacks, him to be able to just put the ball in the position for just his receiver to be able to catch. Like, some of the balls that he threw this game were like, okay, he's throwing the ball for you to be able to catch. Like, I'm putting this ball out of reach so that the DB can't even, like, attempt to be able to bat it down or try to go for an interception. Like if you watch both Ladd McConkey's, like, touchdowns, it was both contested catches that Ladd McConkey had to be able to go up and try to get the ball from, like, the DB. And, you know, Ladd McConkey, he had an amazing game as well. 106 receptions for 111 yards. That one off the contested catch off the sideline and then breaking it out inside all the way for the touchdown. Like, that's what you want from a receiver. Like, I haven't seen a Charger receiver do that for I don't know how long. But leave it to Jim Harbaugh and Joe Ortiz to be able to pick a receiver who's able to do that. And that's probably the only receiver that is that type of, like, wide receiver one caliber that the Chargers have right now. Like, Joshua Palmer, he's a really good receiver. But you don't expect them to be that wide receiver one. Like, two catches, 72 yards. He still had a good day. But Ladd McConkey, he was just on a whole another level. Will Disley still being, like, I'm very surprised on how, like, effective he is for this offense. But yeah, the passing game for this team was clicking. And honestly, like, going into the season, like, I already know Jim Harbaugh and Greg Roman, they wanted this team to be a run first type of, like, team, but it seems like they can't do it. They don't have the O-line to be able to do it effectively. Like, Zion Johnson, Bradley Bozeman, they're just not able to, like, beat teams' defensive lines like that or just get leverage like that. Because J.K. Dobbins, 17 carries, 57 yards, average yards, 3.4 a carry. I mean, it's like, it's not great. I mean, like, going into the season, these are not numbers that you will want. And Justin Herbert already being second for 4 carries, 49 yards. Like the whole reason why this we got Jim Harbaugh and we got Greg Roman and we did these whole, like, changes for the organization was to kind of alleviate the pressure off of Justin Herbert. But it seems like they just have to, like, rely on him, because to me, when Justin Herbert has the ball in his hand, like, that's when the offense is most effective. And I'm liking how Greg Roman is starting to realize that he can't take the ball out of his QB's hand, and they have to be aggressive with the ball, because him just relying on J.K. Dobbins to run up the middle and them to be able to rely on the run game is just not really effective for this offense. Again, J.K. Dobbins, he had some good runs, but it's just not reliable. But again, this team did what they needed to do against a Spencer Rattler, and I don't even know who this dude's name is, like, Jake Heiner. I don't even know who he is. But going to this game, you would expect this Chargers team to kind of blow out this Saints team for where they're at right now. No QB, no starting, no Derek Carr, a lot of injuries on their team. And this Saints team has just been downhill ever since the first 2 weeks, and the Chargers did their job. Shout out to this defense again for doing, like, locking this team up. Like, this Chargers defense is probably the best in the league. Like, for some odd reason, even though, like, the Saints, Like, they still got yardage. Like, let me find, like, the total yardage. Oh, yeah, like, total yards, 366 yards. Like, that's not bad. That's pretty good. But they only came up with 8 points. Like, this team, this Chargers defense, knows how to, like, make teams not score. And that's what matters at the end of the day. Like, the Saints team just could not score. Then again, it is against Spencer Rattler. So, I'm not going to be like, oh my goodness, this Chargers team defense is like top level. Like, actually, I take that back. This Chargers defense is really top level because they've been consistent this entire like season. So, but this Chargers defense did their job against someone who's not really that experienced, is what I should be saying. So yeah, this defense did their job. Joey Bosa, I heard, like, I saw him get hurt again. Honestly, to me, for Joey Bosa, you have to package that dude up and just be, like, ready to send him out, like, trade him or something. Because he makes too much money for him to be injured all the time. But I'm not even going to worry about that right now. It's just because of how good this defense is right now. But, yeah, this game was good. I really enjoyed watching this game, especially in the second half, because watching Justin Herbert actually take shots downfield is what I've been missing for, like, I don't know how long. Jalen Reagor, I don't know where this dude just came from. Even though he did have that mess up in the Cardinals game, he came back and had a huge catch in the second half. Joshua Palmer, huge catch. Ladd McConkey balling out. Will Disley balling out. Like, you wouldn't expect a wide receiver core like this to be, like, putting up numbers like this. But again, it's against a Saints defense that is ranked bottom of the barrel. So, this Chargers team did their job for what they were supposed to be doing against this Saints team. That's why I looked at the spread and they were favored by a touchdown to win against the Saints. Because the Saints, they have their own issues. But I just like it how the Chargers did their job and what they needed to do. But let me know in the comments below what you guys thought about this game. To me, the defense balled out. Justin Herbert, he did his job. He played at an elite level. Do I still have concerns about this offense? Yes. Mainly because you still haven't been able to establish a run. I mean, for rushing, you had 122 yards, so that's good. So, but I need to see this team, what they can do against an actual, like, good defense. So, because so far when they faced against the Chiefs and the Steelers, them just scoring 10 points is not good enough. And I just need to be able to see this Chargers offense be consistent. So, this is a step in the right direction, and I just hope that this Chargers team stays consistent from what they did for this week. Because if they can have a good offense, then this Chargers team is really good. Then it's just a matter of them being consistent. But let me know in the comments below what you guys thought about this game, and I will catch y'all later. Peace.